Boom. And sorry, four schemes. So we got 13, 3 masks and rams. We'll see what those are. All right, guys, we're doing corpse hunt today. So these are our schemes that we generated. We got convict labor, exhaust their force, show of force, occupy their turf, and neutralize later. Neutralize the leader. All right, and we will show you our crews. I brought Yalno with Fortify Spirit and Misdirection. I brought Toshiro, the Daimyo, with Command the Grace, Smoke Grenades, two Kaminu, a Wastrel, a Shadow Effigy, a Tenth Underbrother, and Yasunori with Recall Training.
All right, and I am bringing you another game with the beautiful Colette Dubois. She is bringing Arcane Reservoir, Nothing Up My Sleeve, and Shell Game. She's bringing along all three of her Dove Totems, and now we're going to be trying a filthy trick out for the first time today. I am bringing Killjoy. We've got a mature Nelephim standing in for him today. And then accompanying her is her right-hand woman, Cassandra, and two performers. So we're going to get to see how the Killjoy with Colette does.
Two I picked.
And here are my schemes.
All right, flipping for planet.
Right. Eight. I'm going to go ahead and pick this corner. I like it. So you've got that corner. Now we're going to place our course markers.
So we're playing Corpse Hunt. This is weeks 3-4 of the Trickster. So in this one, we have a single Trickster model. It is a 30 millimeter impassable. No other kind of terrain, so you just can't you can't move through it normally. But you can shoot across it. Now what we want to do, so we each place two corpse markers. So we've got, you can see the four of them. We've already determined that I will be deploying here. Steve will be across from me, corner deployment. The goal is you're able to interact with a corpse marker to place it on the model's card if you're in base contact. Then, if you are within 1 inch of the Trickster, you can interact with her and remove any corpse markers on your card. If you do, you score one victory point up to a maximum of 6. So the entire goal is to give the Trickster as many corpses as you can. As you can see, we only start with 4, but each of us can store 6 points, so we're going to have to kill each other if we want to get extra points off of that strategy.
Which is going to be very hard.
Yes, we both have crews that don't have overly number of corpse markers, so this is going to be very interesting to see how this goes for the Trickster. Yep.
Shall we flip
for... flipping for first turn.
First turn.
Okay, you take the first turn.
Oh, wait, shouldn't we draw our hands first? Initiative for turn one.
Seven. I will not Soulstone.
I will have you go first, Casey.
Okay, here's my hand for turn one.
My hand for turn one.
I was just waiting for you then.
Yeah. All right, activating this Dove. Has flight and 10-inch movement, so he's going to go over here. Do I need a second move? Nah, he's just going to stop there and chill.
All right. Okay. Activating the Wastrel, he's going to walk twice. Walk. And walk right to there. Yeah. And then he's going to go... And because he double walked, he gets to go defensive for free.
Yep, because he only took walk. Right. Activating this Dove... He is going to fly over behind this rock, and that's his action.
Aren't doves gender neutral? Because you said it's a he or a she.
Well, not doves so much as mechanical.
Oh, okay.
Doves.
Oh, yeah. Well, like ships. Machines. So does she? Does like Colette, when she makes a dove, does she like christen them with like?
Yeah, that's the SS George, SS John, SS Jimmy.
Oh, there's always a Bill, though. I mean.
But, sure, one of them can be Bill.
All right, now my turn.
Activating Bob the Kaminu. Because, you know, if she can name her doves, I can name my Kaminu. I don't think Yalno builds them, though. He's going to walk 5? Yeah, he has walk a 5. He's going to walk another 5 right over here. And he'll be done.
Hiding behind the building.
All right, so I'm activating this performer.
Yes.
I'm going to walk 5. And she's got 5 more. She's gonna mosey over to this base contact with this course marker. She's within 8 inches of Colette, so as a zero action, she's going to interact to pick up the marker.
Okay.
And that is her activation.
Right. I'm activating the effigy. I'm going to double walk. 5 right to here. Another 5. Right. Base contact with that.
Right. All corpsified and whatnot.
There we go.
All right, Casey.
Okay. Going to activate this performer. She's within Colette's aura. So she's going to start with a zero action. Place a scheme marker. Then 5-inch walk, and place a second scheme marker.
Cool. Okay, I'm going to activate a 10th Thunder Brother. He's going to do, first thing, his Dance of the Heavens. That would give him armor. I'm going to change that to 3-inch place.
Right.
Boom. I should have done that the other way, but...
Should have waited.
Yeah, but you know what? I can just go around. So 2 and 2. Right, right there. And base contact with that corpse.
Yeah.
Activating Cassandra. She has 5-inch walk. So this is her nimble AP. Then she is going to use a second to move to there. And a third, or her last general AP to interact and pick up the corpse marker. Goes on her card. And... actually, you know what? I've got lots of cards. I'm going to use Southern Hospitality, discard card.
Okay.
Activating this other Camino. It's going to walk 5. To there. That was a little too far. Then another 5. Right to here. It'll be done.
I'm going to activate Colette. So on her nothing up my sleeve, I'm using Soulstone Manipulation. So one action, I'm going to discard a Soulstone to draw 2 cards.
Putting it down to 6.
Yep. I am... God, why is everything a bad option?
Hold on. It's Colette.
Yep, so Colette, her second AP... She's going to use Prompt on this performer. So easily within range. Here we go. So it's cast. I'm going to cheat in 6 of Tomes to get the Surge trigger. So first, the performer is pushed 3 up to 3 inches. Push her to there. Then she takes a 1 AP action, interact, to drop a scheme marker.
All right.
And then after succeeding, draw a card for the Surge trigger.
Yep.
Super hand. Yep. So for her second, she is going to prompt this performer.
Yep.
I'm going to use artificial soul stone to add a tome.
Sure.
So I need a 6, and I have the tome for surge. So this performer is pushed 3 inches. And then she's going to take a walk action, 2.5 to get up to there. And surge trigger to draw a card. And then 0 AP.
Oh, doesn't she get a 1 AP action?
Hmm? It started with the card draw. She did a walk. She pushed 3
into. Oh, you did a walk. Okay.
Yes, I get you now.
With all the pushes and stuff.
Yeah. Sure, she's going to use Shell Game. This dove, so all doves and mannequins within a 4-inch pulse, just mm-hmm. this guy, are moved and placed within 4 inches.
Okay.
So he's going to be placed there. And that ends Colette.
All right, then it is my turn next.
I see your Colette's fancy schmancy tricks, and I raise you Yon Lo's fancy schmancy tricks. So first thing, it's tactics.
I didn't say anything. All
right. Under your breath. He's going to charge.
Charge his own model.
How dare I? I'm a traitor's dog. All right. So this is the first flip for the Wastrel.
So Wastrel, he has... Because
he's defensive, he flips two cards.
With one, defensive.
And then for me?
Yon Lo.
For Yon Lo. Oh, good job, Yon Lo. You're a fantastic dude.
That worked out just as planned, right?
Yeah, just as planned. I'm going to cheat down a Joker.
Black Joker, that Wastrel's getting hit.
Yep, and then I'm going to... Oh, beforehand, I forgot to mention, I have to discard a card to give Yon Lo one chi.
So usually, at the beginning of his turn, he's going to discard one card.
That's the card I'm discarding. And then I'm cheating in a 12,
okay,
making it 17 to 4. So that's a
positive twist. Positive flip.
One, two. I'm going to cheat in a severe.
Severe damage. So severe, you get one chi for dealing severe.
Yes.
And that's leaves a Wastrel at one hit point, right?
One hit point,
yeah.
And then next attack.
Second attack from the charge.
This is from
Wastrel. Wastrel.
Okay, Yon Lo.
One for Yon Lo.
Oh, well, you're right. You're correct. Okay.
But
so I hit.
That looks like a hit.
A five.
So with a negative twist.
Negative twist.
Looks like.
So it kills.
Kills him, getting him one more chi.
Giving me a chi and placing a corpse right here.
So, Yon Lo is currently at 3 chi from that.
Yeah. At 3 chi. And what I'm going to do now is he has 1 AP left.
Which 1 AP and a 0, right?
And a 0, which would he would need to do.
Starting?
Yep, yeah, for Yon Lo. Yon Lo is going to walk.
So, last AP.
Walk 4 right to here. And then he is going to do his zero action, which is Ascendance. How Ascendant works is I would lower his chi value to get a specific upgrade that has the Ascendant. So I'm going to reduce his chi from 3 to 1 to give him Spirit Ascendant, which would give him it would give him Incorporeal and Fear of Yomi, which up to 3 Spirit Models within 8 may immediately take a 1 action.
Right. So, Spirit Synergy, which not here, but he has Incorporeal is the main point.
Yeah. And that's...
All right.
And that's Yon Lo's
done. He's starting with the Dove.
Yep. This Dove, he's going to activate. He's going to fly over into this corner. And he's done.
All right.
All right.
I'm going to activate Toshiro. He's going to walk. He has a walk of 5. He's going to walk 5. Right. To here and not miss with that. And I'm going to attempt to summon off that Corpse Marker.
Right. Alright.
I'm going to attempt Eternal Servitude. I am not using a Soul Stone. I need a Nine of Crows to be able to summon something. To summon a Ashigaru. That's a Crows. Well, drop an 11.
Crows.
And replace him. And remove the Corpse Marker. He takes half damage, so he's down
to 3. Alright.
And that's my end of turn. So
Yasunori.
You are correct, Yasunori.
And the slow Ashigaru. You're
even more correct about that.
But yeah, go ahead.
I believe the Ash
is gonna
walk
4. Hey,
Rings. Right. And then he is done.
All
right. And then Yasunori. He's a walk of 6. Six to here. And he ignores train because he's a flying motherfucker. Fly, motherfucker, fly!
Second turn, initiative flip.
I got a 2!
Got an 11. Hold on, I need to think about
this. Casey.
It. I'm going to activate Cassandra.
Okay.
We're going to start with her nimble action. She has a total of 5. There's 3 inches.
Mm-hmm.
And then 2 inches. So then she's going to use a general AP to walk. Let's see. So that she is within 1. She's going to use her last general AP to interact with her, giving the corpse marker to the trickster.
Okay.
And I score 1 victory point.
So and 1 VP for Casey.
Yeah. I'm going to discard a card to gain Southern Hospitality.
All right. And then to my turn.
Cassandra's done. Yes.
Activating this lonely little Camino back here. He's going to walk 5. Right there. He's going to walk another 5 right to here. And that Camino is done.
All right. Going to activate this dove. So his first fly will get him there. And the second, so this is a height 3 building, so I lose 3 inches going up, which means I can go over up to 7, which is still plenty of room.
Right to there.
And that dove's going to end right there.
Okay.
Okay.
Activating this Camino right here. He's going to double walk. Walk 5.
Camino buddies!
Right to there. And another 5. Right to here.
Okay.
He's done.
All right, here's my hand for turn 2.
Hand for turn 2. Oh, there's one more card. There you go.
All right, Casey's turn.
Activating yellow performer. So it's going to take an inch to get out of this forest. And then I've got a few more. Stupid Camino. Hold on, sorry. Okay. Then she's going to walk a little more forward. So she can get within range of this Ashigaru for her Siren's Call, and going to use Siren's Call on the Ashigaru.
Sure.
This is willpower.
Willpower of 5, so 12.
I'm at 17 total.
So I'd make a walk towards you, and...
So you would be pushed equal to your walk towards me.
Okay. Walk of 5.
It's also a straight line. You're going to hit the trickster.
Oh, okay.
On the way.
I let go. Yeah.
Not okay, close. So you're not going to cheat.
Yeah.
Ashigaru gets pushed straight towards me, hits the trickster. That ends the performer.
Okie doke.
All right.
I'm going to activate Toshiro for his first action. I'm going to attempt to summon off of this course marker.
Okay.
I'm not going to spend soul stone.
Summon an Ashigaru. Yeah. All right.
I need, I should state was it's a turtle servitude, which will summon a Ashigaru, which I need a corpse. 9 of crows. Nope, that's not a 9 of crows. But I do have a 12 of crows.
Okay.
And I summon another Ashigaru. I gotta pull him out, so he might want to pause.
Yep. There's the Ashigaru.
Summon right there, and I bump it a little bit. Remove the corpse marker. And then I'm going to attempt to warfan this Ashigaru to give it fast. I need a... eight of masks. Or I need an 8 of anything, but an 8 of masks to give it push. Nope. But I do have a 9 of masks. All right. So push, so give him fast.
Push, cancels out slow.
Yeah. 4-inch push. Right to there.
Alright.
He's done.
He's got a 1 action, right?
Yeah. Oh, he has 2 actions. No. He has 1 action. Okay, yeah, yeah.
Right, we're still in Toshiro.
Toshiro is going to walk 5 right to there. And he'll be done.
Okay.
Right before the playing, Casey.
All right, just double checking. Activating this performer.
Mm-hmm.
She's going to start with a walk action, so through the forest. She ends up with a net 2.5 from 5.
Okay.
Gets her over here with a single walk.
Okay.
And then she is going to use Siren's Call on this Ashigaru.
Sure. Is this willpower? Black Joker.
Willpower. Okay. Yeah. So he is pushed equal to his walk. They said walk 5?
Yes.
Or 4. 5. Okay. Faster than they look. Hold on. Line it up with her.
Yeah. Boom.
And that pushes him there. No 0 actions, so she's done.
Okay.
Okay, activating.
Yeah, I play the Ashigaru. He's going to walk 5 back to where he was. Right to there. And for his other action, you know what? He'll walk another 5. Right. Actually, he'll dirtle about right here. He has plenty of movement to get.
Yeah, he'll move a little back to the side.
Yeah, so if I get pushed, I get pushed in to the thing. Yeah, that's good. And okay. Bill for his other... Yeah, he's done.
Zero.
He's done.
Okay, no 0s.
Sure.
Alright, activating this dove. He's going to start by flying 10 inches. And he's got 10 more inches. He's going to fly over to there.
Alright. And then he's done.
Yep.
Okay. Activating the Ashigaru. The Ashigaru is going to spend his first action. He's going to move a little bit. That's a 3-inch push for Colette's thing, right?
She gets a 3-inch push before the prompt, yes.
Okay. I'm going to go a little right to here. And then I'm going to spend one action bracing.
So he uses Brace Yari.
Yeah.
All right. So I'm going to activate this dove.
Yep.
He is going to fly there, and he's done.
Okay.
Or action. Yes. He's flying there, and he's done. That's exactly it.
Okie doke. He's done.
Activating the effigy. I'm going to spend one action removing the course marker.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm going to walk 5 right to here. And he will be done.
Okay.
Activating Colette.
Yeah, or Colette, activating Colette. I'm going to start by using one action, soulstone manipulation.
Okay.
Discard a soulstone to draw 2 cards. Then she is going to use Disappearing Act on, she is targeting herself, okay. A friendly model within 3. It's a tactical action. All right, so she needs a 5. It is cast. So a scheme marker right there, 18 in line of sight.
Mm-hmm.
So she is placed in base contact. Marker is removed. That was 2 AP. He is going to target Cassandra with prompt.
Sure.
She's going to spend a soul stone to add a tome to this total.
And that's going to be for the artificial soul stone.
Artificial soul stone in this case. And I do, so first of all, I do have soul stones to spend.
Yes.
So technically I spend one and get it back.
Okay.
Because
you have to have one in your pool to be able to do it. You have to have
one in the pool to be able to do it.
Yes.
Prompt. Cast. So, Cassandra mm-hmm. is going to use the understudy action.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, she's going to copy Cassandra's prompt.
Mm-hmm.
It
begins.
To use prompt on Cassandra.
All right,
cast with the surge trigger.
Without using the stuff.
Well, first, on her prompt, the first thing she does is push 3.
Okay.
I'm going to push her 3 inches. Oh, where do I want her? Yeah. Over here. And then she prompts Cassandra, which just passed. Or Cassandra prompt Colette. Colette gets her push. She's going to just... she's going to go over there. Yeah, that's good. Now she takes... Colette takes a 1 AP action.
Mm-hmm.
She's going to prompt this bird.
All right,
I need a 6 to pass. So, that's what I forgot. Oh, well.
Good.
Bird is pushed. That doesn't matter. Bird takes a 1 AP action.
There was a little miscommunication with something.
Yes. So on this last prompt in the chain, I'm spending a soul stone to add a ram.
Yeah.
Now I flipped a 4, which is not enough, so I cheat in the 6.
Yep.
So now I have cast.
Yes.
I'm choosing the give this dove reactivate.
Okay.
And that's what the ram is. Dove is going to move to... there's fine. Now, all those prompts are done. I had 2 surge triggers during that. So I draw. Because I have a 0 action, which I will use to take a 0, interact as a 0,
mm-hmm.
and place a scheme marker. And Colette is done.
Okay. Damn.
Activate my 10th Thunder Brother.
Mm-hmm.
He is going to walk 5. He's going to walk around 5 to here. Boom. An engagement of one for the bird, right?
Technically, the bird doesn't have an engagement.
Oh, okay.
So however, if you're within range of it,
it's still your
can is engaged. Okay.
Well, then
right. So I can't strike at you.
Yeah. And then I'm going to do my dance.
Dance like your life depends on it.
That's crow's
reach.
That would give me a reach of 4 inches. But then you could just sacrifice the bird. I'm going to go for the 3-inch place.
Okay.
Right about there.
Oh, okay. Yeah, back to center. That's his final after the place.
Yep.
Is it right. Birdie?
Yep. So I'm just going to be finding the exact place I want to put it. So, all right, that's within 2 inches of Yanlo. 2 inches of this guy. Okay, so he takes a one action to walk there.
Mm-hmm.
And then he's taking a one action to take the detonate soul stone. So all models within a 2-inch pulse must pass a 14 defense duel or suffer 2 damage, then sacrifice this model. So,
okay. I'll flip for... Oh.
Just to double check, I am out with Xandra, so... Yeah, it's your symbol duels.
Okay. All right, first thing I'm going to do Yanlo.
Yanlo.
He'll take 2 damage. He'll take 1 damage. So, or is it pulse?
It is not melee. It is not shooting, so he would take the full 2.
I'll take 2. Okay, but, no big deal.
So not going to cheat. He takes 2. All
right, then the Ashigaru.
Uh-huh.
No, the effigy.
Effigy first.
What's the target number? 14?
14 versus defense.
He'll take 1 damage.
Armor 1.
Yeah, and then the Ashigaru. He'll take 1 damage as well.
Armor.
Yeah, armor. Yeah. All right, and then I'll do the damages right now, and...
Yep, record that. So,
and then,
before being removed, I am going to place Killjoy. So, didn't quite work out. All of you on camera saw how terrible my turn 1 hand was. So I did not want to bring Killjoy out on that. And then the bird is removed. I'll sacrifice to the god of the blood.
The blood.
All right,
and my turn.
Yep, okay.
All right, so what I'm going to do is activating Yanlo. I'm going to lightning dance with Killjoy.
Yep.
Okay, resist.
Casting 7.
Oh, sorry, first thing.
Oh, okay, he's activating, so he's going to...
Gonna this is currently at a cast of 6. What's his willpower?
I see. Willpower is 5.
Willpower is 5. No, I won't.
So you're not discarding a card for chi?
No.
So you're staying at 1 chi.
Lightning okay. Dance. Casting. 18.
Okay, I'm not cheating.
Alright, so I'll place a base.
Yes, so first Yanlo jumps into base contact. Base
contact. And sends you within a model with an 8.
Yep, 8 of Yanlo.
I'm gonna send you a 2. Him.
Mm-hmm. In base contact with the 10 Thunder Brother.
Yeah. Right there. And then I'm going to attempt to... So,
Yanlo's got some more.
The Lightning Dance with the birdie.
Yep. Right. This is the trickster does not block line of sight.
Yeah, that's we one discussed key part. Because in the...
Yeah, it doesn't block line of sight. You just can't walk on it.
All right. I'm going to attempt to dance with the bird.
All right.
Casting. Got a 9. What's the willpower?
16.
Bird?
It's 4.
4. So then.
Here, let's.
I'll make it a 19.
Alright, 19. I'm not cheating.
Okay, so I place a base of the birdie. And then. Boom. And I'm going to send the birdie.
Friendly model with an 8 in line of sight.
Yeah. Right there.
Okay. So.
And I've got 1 AP left.
Yep.
I'm going to attempt to... Wait 1 second. Within 8. Okay. Nah, I am...
Done after that.
I've got 1 AP left. Here, I need to think.
Close.
He's going to spend a 0 to attempt to instill youth on...
the wounded Ashigaru. They're both wounded, but the more wounded.
Yeah, the more wounded one. Instill youth.
plus my chi, which puts me at 12. He would heal 1 damage at that point.
Anything you want to cheat?
Oh, wait, that pin... Nope, it doesn't even meet the target number.
Oh, so it's not cast.
Yeah, it's not cast. So I'm just going to walk for my last one.
So last AP, walk.
Walk forward to there.
Okay.
And then we'll be done.
All right. Casey's
all right, so activating Killjoy.
All right.
Attack on the 10 Thunder Brother.
All right. Defense 6. 17.
Also 17.
Would
you like to cheat?
No, I'm not going to cheat.
All right. You're not going to cheat. Cheat it to 19.
Okay.
It's one negative flip, and the mask, I have the trigger to take the attack.
Additional attack. Okay.
Attack against the same target.
Okay.
So negative flip on damage. Just first time with Killjoy, so I'm double checking all of his wording.
Yeah.
All right. Oh!
Severe.
7 damage.
That kills the 10th Other Brother.
Okay.
Bam. He is dead.
On slight, after damaging, take another against the same target. Okay. And then declare triggers. Oh, that was awfully quick.
And I get a chi for Yama.
Yes.
Enemy oh, corpse! Model. We forgot the corpse. Forgot about the corpse marker and we placed it.
Yep. Alright, you can pause for a second. Yeah, thing. So Killjoy is not wounded, but he still gets a healing flip after killing the 10 Thunder Brother. So we do need to flip the card. Yeah, that would be 3 damage.
Cool.
Alright. Okay, so Killjoy, start on his slow jog around this stupid bird. So his 4-inch movement gets him there.
Alright. And then my turn. Right. Activating yep. Yasunori. Yasunori is going to charge. We pre-measured this, and we both agreed that he was going to be just out of black blood.
So he's
going
to engage Cassandra?
Yes.
Okay. So
out of black blood.
So right there is out of black blood. 2-inch engagement on both of them.
Cool. All right. First thing, I'm going to... also, I'm going to burn recall train with...
Yep.
Okay. All right. So first attack. Melee 6. So flipping 3 cards. 1, 2, 3. 17.
16. And of course you have a trigger.
Yeah.
Oh, that's what we forgot. Okay. Terrify cards. All.
Oh, flipping for terrify.
And remember recall training.
Oh, yeah. Recall training.
All duels. So
11. Does that pass?
13. That's what you're looking at.
I'll cheat it to make sure it.
Okay. So you cheated in to pass the terrifying. So now you're hitting me on a... What's your total again?
18.
You're at 18?
Yes. Or sorry, 17. 17.
Okay, 17. Yasunori is your last model, right?
Yes.
Okay. I'll make it an 18.
I'll cheat it to a 19.
All right.
So that would be a negative... Oh, no, so that would normally be a negative...
A negative to a straight.
To a straight flip because of recall training.
Yep.
Severe of 5 damage.
So 5 damage to Killjoy... Dove takes 1 damage. Yep. Second attack.
So 1, 2, 3. 14.
You're at 14?
Yes.
No cards in hand?
No.
14.
Oh, Oh, that was the trigger. Sorry, I forgot to clear the trigger.
Yeah, we didn't say it. I assumed you were doing the Tome's trigger.
Yeah.
You're going to have 1 attack after this. Well... Minus any, plus any trigger. Cheated up to a 17.
Okay, next attack. 1, 2, 3. 15.
So, now I'm trying to think. The crow is with the tome, right, on the trigger?
The trigger is, yeah.
So, okay. And you've got, for the rams, that's a 6?
Yes.
That'd be a 12. Ugh. And that's a 9.
Yes.
All right. Or actually, can we pause? I'm going to cheat in to a 12.
To a 12? All right, and I'll take the...
take the 9?
Or I'll take the ram.
Okay, you're going to tie.
So tie.
Single negative flip.
Single negative, okay. 1, 2. Another 5 damage.
Okay. 10 taken, 2 on the dove.
All right, and then my last attack action.
Yes, with the trigger.
So 1, 2. Oh.
Okay, Black Joker.
All right, I'll take this. I'm at 16.
4 to 16, positive flip.
Positive flip. 1, 2. Another.
Okay. So that kills Killjoy and the dove.
Yep, and Yolo gets 2 chi.
No. He gets 1 for Killjoy.
Oh, you're right. You're correct. You're correct. Yes.
The dove was killed by a friendly.
It wasn't an enemy thing. Yeah.
Yeah. Killjoy leaves a corpse.
Yep.
Yeah.
And, yeah, I'm done. All right. We both have show real show of force. So putting me at 1 to Casey's 2.
Yep.
All right. And then, okay.
All right.
Now going into turn 3. So initiative for turn 3.
Would you like to stone? To try and beat an 11.
No, I'm not going to stone.
Okay, not worth it.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to activate Cassandra.
Sure.
Before I forget, I'll discard for Southern Hospitality.
Okay.
She's going to focus with 1 general AP.
Yep.
Then she is going to use Understudy, copying Siren's Call and targeting him. So normally I'd be at a negative twist, and I'm using focus.
Mm-hmm.
Normally I'd be at a negative twist from Stubborn, so it's a straight flip.
Okay.
Versus willpower to use Siren's Call.
Okay. Willpower 6. 19.
All right. I'm not cheating. Cassandra's done.
Okay. Ow. Activating Asanori to attack Cassandra.
Yep.
First card.
So negative cancels out your negative positive. So you're just straight flip.
Yeah, straight. At a 12.
14.
14. I'll cheat it. I'll cheat it to an 18.
So, an 18?
Yes. Or and 18. I'm declaring the trigger for an extra attack.
Right. You're at 18, yeah. So I'll go to 19.
Oh, okay. All right, next attack.
So, second AP.
It's an 8.
Would you like to cheat, Casey? So it's my cheat.
Yes.
Or, hold on. Because, yes, we're tied at 8, so it is my cheat.
Yeah.
Throw in my 12 to make it a 7, 19.
Make it a 19.
You need a 13 to tie.
Nah, not going to cheat.
Okay. Zero action.
Do Great Sage. I need a casting. Need a 5.
Okay, Great Sage.
It goes off. I get to look at the top 3 cards.
He is indeed a Great Sage.
Yeah, top 3 cards. And put them in any order. Oh, get back to the order I want.
Activating Colette.
Yep.
Colette is going to use Prompt on Cassandra.
Sure.
So I need a 6. I will spend an Artificial Soul Stone to add a Tome.
Okay.
So cast with Surge. So, where... Alright, I'm going to push within 1 inch.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to take an interact action to exhaust Yasunori.
Okay.
So Yasunori is currently exhausted. Colette is going to prompt Cassandra again.
Okay.
Yeah, here's the prompt. It is not cast currently. Oh, sure. Cheat in. So first I get a 3-inch push. Actually, he's at 1 wound now?
No, he healed. Oh, no, he's at 2.
He's at 2, because he only took 1 out of 3.
Yes.
And he's got 2 left. There we go, 2. So push 3 inches to there.
Okay.
Now I need to decide who to attack. But 2 attacks to kill him, 2 or more to kill him. So 1 against the...
you need 2 attacks to kill both of them. Because they both have hard to kill.
2 or more.
Oh, okay.
This might be more than 2. Okay. He's definitely 2.
Defense 5.
Yeah.
12.
6 on my attack. Cheat in 9 brings it to 15.
I'll let go.
Okay. So 15, what do you got?
I'm at 12.
15 to 12, 1 negative twist.
Oh, sorry, 11. 11.
Still 1 negative twist. Yeah, just
thought changed.
Yep. Yeah, make sure to be precise. So that's going to be 1 damage. Or 2.
Because of armor 1, yeah.
Okay. And then the third AP, still within prompt range, prompting her again.
Sure.
I need a 6. Fuck you. To cast prompt. So I get my 3-inch push. I'm going to go to exactly 2 inches.
Okay.
And now I'm going to hit him with the saber again.
Sure.
Or actually, on that prompt, rather than just being 2, I'm going to push the full 3 inches.
Okay.
So I'm currently not engaged with anybody. And I'm going to use Breath of Fire on the Ashigaru.
Sure. Ten.
I'm at 12.
Oh, sorry, 14.
Okay.
Sorry. You, the weird math.
Okay. Or.
Oh, I'll let go.
Okay. So, you're currently at what is it?
I'm at 9.
So you're at 9.
Yeah.
To be a straight flip against a 9, I need. 15. So I will cheat that into a 17.
Okay.
With swirl of motion trigger. So that's a straight flip. Does he have hard to
kill, yes.
Hard to wound? Hard to kill, but not hard to wound.
Not hard to wound.
Okay, so regular straight flip. So severe.
Kills him.
However, before you remove him, I get 2 blast markers.
Oh, damn it. Okay. Oh, I didn't know the blast markers.
I thought you caught that when I was talking about why and breath.
Just do it, yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
What's the damage on it?
Ready? Hold on.
Alright, I'm going to activate the effigy. He's going to double walk. Or he's going to walk right here. And he's going to give her a corpse marker. So it puts me...
Yep. So that puts you. We're currently at 2-2.
Puts her at 2. And then afterwards, I'm going to...
Yeah.
That's all my actions.
No zeros for the effigy. Okay.
And actually, you know what?
Oh.
He does have a 0. I forgot about that. I'm going to blend into shadows. Friendly with 8 gains. Target by attack action puts a negative. I could choose the discard to put it. I forgot about that.
Yes, I should have
been about that for 2 turns. Oh my god, I'm an idiot. All right.
Yeah, well, Yon Lo's tough enough. People often just ignore him.
Yeah.
But okay, so, all right. So after Cassandra's whole kerfuffle, we remembered that Exhaust is a 2-action if the model's already activated, so she was not able to exhaust Yasunori. So, basically, he's just not exhausted. That particular AP was wasted. Alright.
Okay.
Activating this performer. Yep. She is going to use her Siren's Call on the effigy.
Okay.
Come here, little boy.
He's actually a puppet. 12.
Yeah. With the soul of boy.
Okay. No, sorry. Willpower 11.
So you're 11, that fails, can't cheat. Second time I'm going to do the same thing. Siren's Call.
Okay. Go for it.
Okay, so he's walk 5?
Yeah.
Probably? Okay. So he's pushed 5. He doesn't reach base contact, so my pro trigger doesn't matter.
Phew.
And that performer, yes, there's nowhere I can place a scheme marker, I don't think. Let me just double check.
I think on the other side. Oh, no.
No, this one is
Okay.
Just over to that side of her base with
javelins. Oh, okay.
So she's done. No zero.
Alrighty.
Alright. First thing, going to attempt to summon off of this corpse marker.
Okay.
I need a nine of crows. I'm same thing, I'm gonna try to summon Ashigar.
Yep.
Doesn't go off. Okay. Cheat. Good cheat. A nine. Exactly yep. what I need. I'm gonna summon Ashigar. Right.
Keep those cold bodies on the field.
Yep. Little corpse. And then what I'm going to do is, excuse me. I'm going to attempt to warfan this Ashigar right behind.
Okay, the one that's already there.
Yes. And I need a 8 of anything for this to go off. Goes off.
No mask? All right.
Oh, shoot. I should have stoned. God damn it.
Oh, I see. So
no biggie.
But that Ashigaru is fast, so he'll have 3 AP.
Yep, and he is done.
All right, Shiro's done. Shiro does have 1 more AP, right?
Oh, he does 1 more.
The standard AP?
He's going to move right just within 6 of this.
Right, back up a little.
It'll be done.
All right, so this bird is gonna...
You said it kind of like a southern drawl.
He's gonna dirtle about, get out of dodge.
All right.
He's done.
Okay, my turn.
Okay, go ahead.
I'm gonna attack Cassandra because of the Toshiro. I'm at a straight flip.
Yep, cancels out Southern Hospitality.
Melee 5.
Yep, defense 7.
9.
20.
nothing to do.
Okay. Right, he was slow, so he's done.
All right, activating this performer.
Mm-hmm.
So it's 1.5 inches to get out, so I have to spend 3 inches of movement to get there.
Mm-hmm.
I've got 2 more. Then another walk to get within 1 inch.
Mm-hmm.
Now, as a zero action, since she's within Colette's aura, she's going to interact, and since she has Don't Mind Me, to give a corpse marker to the trickster, and I go to 3 points.
All right. So my turn.
Yep.
Is that your last model, Casey?
Yep, that's my last model. Okay, so it's cool. Just you.
Now we can
Amino time.
Amino, he's going to walk 5, and walk another 5 this way.
Mm-hmm.
Same thing with this one. 5 right to here. Another 5 right to there.
All right, that's the Camino's getting. Seem to be going towards my board edge. I wonder why that is. All right, and.
Activating this Ashigaru. Alright, why don't we pause it? Activating this Ashigaru. He's going to triple move because of fast.
He's got 3 walks.
Right up to here.
I'll be about there.
Right there. And we use the token just to pre-measure everything.
Yep.
So.
And. Now we're going to go into.
Yamo hasn't. Has he? Yeah.
I'm going to attempt to dance with Cassandra.
Okay. So you're at a negative twist for her Southern Hospitality?
Oh, shoot. I'm going to focus and do it then.
Okay, focus and dance.
Casting of 8.
I have nothing to cheat. It succeeds.
Okay, and base contact of you.
Yep, you jump to me.
Boom. And then I'm going to send you to Shiro. Right there. And then I'm going to... actually, I want to ensure that you can. I'm going to dance with this performer right here.
Okay, one second. It's Leon's last AP, right?
Yeah. I'm going to attempt to dance with this performer right here.
Okay.
Okay, lightning dance. Casting 8.
Okay.
All right. I'm going to place in base right to here.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to have to send you with an 8.
Yeah, looks like...
Here, we'll pre-measure everything. We'll
get back. All right, yep.
Okay, I'm going to send him to this Ashigaru right over here.
Mm-hmm.
Boop. Right there. And then I'm going to, last but not least, Colette Dubois.
No, you had to focus against...
You're correct! Sorry, my mistake.
No worries.
I'm going to... There's nothing else I can do with the zeros. There's no reason. Okay,
he's done. So he's done. Is that your last model?
Yeah.
Okay, so end of the turn. You have pushed me out of show force range, so
within, so that puts me
score
at 3.
I've got none exhausted, so we're tied, and I'm gonna call it there because at this point,
we'll talk more about it in the post game.
Yeah, at this point, I'm really not gonna score anything. You got me pretty well. You're gonna get your 3 points for your 3 minions over here next turn. Yeah, so
yeah, good game. Good game. It's fun.
Yeah, that was. It was very fun. It was nice to play Colette again after kind of a break. We've been doing a lot of the other factions with our campaign, so...
Yeah,
well,
like,
I have.
With this game, though, it was just... I think Yanlo was the... Like, I didn't... You didn't know Yanlo was coming. And Yanlo is, like, the answer.
Well, it's also... This particular one had all its eggs in one basket with Killjoy, which can work out, but it's not always good.
Yeah.
It was just interesting to see how it went. Like we... Like I said in the game, that opening hand, it was just so bad, and even drawing about 4 extra cards through Colette, it was still terrible.
Yeah.
And like we said, unless you have some massive positive flips, and even then you can't rely on them, like, you had your full hand.
Yes.
So you had some face cards I saw you start dropping once my turn was over.
Yeah, I had like 13. I had like, on turn 2, I had 3 13s.
So Killjoy wouldn't have done anything turn 1 anyway, so... So that was interesting to see how he goes. I still think Yasunari, oh, he's so beefy. But, yeah, he does have his weaknesses. So.
Yeah, well, like, the thing about it is I had to say, like,
well, you were... Well, against Cassandra, you whiffed because I had 7 defense and good cards.
Yeah. And, you know, I would have had to
cheat. Anyways.
I would need a lot of 13s. Also, I think the mission, too, really did play.
It was a very strange one. I honestly thought I'd see distract from you more, just because Yanlo can send you to this guy and...
Yeah.
Oh, you've activated? I'm going to send you to this Ashigaru.
I like, kids, you know, we meet but, you play a lot, and I was thinking, like, oh, man. Like, the scheme pool wasn't... There was no easy schemes. Like, there's nothing really...
Well, Show of Force is the closest.
Yeah, Show of Force.
There's clearly a reason we both took it.
Yeah, but all the other ones seem very difficult. Because how my playstyle is, I don't like putting conditions on you and keeping you alive. That's just my personal preference. That's why I was like, oh, why don't I try outflank for once? Because my plan was just to summon enough models that I could possibly... And I knew...
Yeah, the occupy their turf.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I've had that used once against me, but they were playing Molly. Mm-hmm. So they shoved Molly in my face and then started summoning punks in my backfield.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, that's...
But, this scheme pool was really... it was a tough one. You know...
I had 3 or 4 different masters. I'm like, well, I could make this work. I could make that work.
Mm-hmm. I think Raymond, like you said, yeah... No one's seen Colette in a while on the channel. And that's one of the reasons why I brought Yanlo. I mean, like, what? It's been like 3 or 4 games since I brought Yanlo. And he's he's one of my favorite masters. And he did very well. Well, he didn't really do that much.
Okay, I think this game is a pretty good example of exactly what Yanlo is supposed to do, though. Like, he made sure Cassandra didn't score me points. He kept Helheaven freed up. You saw how I threw a bird just to keep Yasunori from being able to charge.
Mm-hmm.
Well, he moves that bird. Yeah. You can't just rely on one thing tying somebody down.
I really do like this list. Well, you know, I had, 8 models initially, and being able to summon 2 more.
Yeah, and one of them is there just to die.
Yeah, yeah.
So, Yanlo getting his first turn extra chi.
Yeah.
Yeah, like you said, it's very good to be able to replace that model with the Ashigaru, get them summoned, and... Yeah.
But it was a fun game case.
Indeed.
So our seconds, she became 10 Thunders again, even though in the fluff she worked for McMorning. We'll see you guys during the next week, and we'll see how that game goes. Play Malifaux, guys. Bye.